Another book I found that I even learned from is called 1 Million Men and Me. And this book is by Kelly Starling Lyons. So this book talks about the Million Man March, when African American men especially were called to Washington, D.C. So the unique thing about this book is one of the dads decided to bring his daughter to this march. So the 1 Million Men and Me refers to the millions of black men and then this little black girl. So we get a different view or perspective than maybe other history books would talk about, or in, so it's in a different perspective. So I actually hadn't learned about the Million Man March, so this book really opened my eyes to that event. It took place in 1995, so it not only brings the event to life, but within the book, it talks about, you know, what she's viewing and how the little girl is feeling as she's walking through the crowd. And she talks about seeing the different shades of men. And I think a lot of the times, you know, students just see black. You know, we don't, like, address the different shades or whatever. But it's important to have the different shades represented, because just like in It's All Good, the little black girl has darker skin than her mom. So I think the book talked about how one of the students made a comment about that as well. But I think the main focus on this book is about this march and how important it was, but we don't talk about it. So this could be used as a window or mirror as well for students. It could be used as a window for students who had never heard about this event, or, you know, I'm sure nobody's talked about it in the classroom. Or it can be used as a mirror just for those minority students to see themselves in a children's book. I think it could raise a lot of good conversations in your classroom. Like I said, I'd never heard about the event, so maybe your class will become interested and want to learn more about the event based on this short story that you read.